My dad lives in what he calls an old people apartment building. And I was like, Dad, you're 84. What's old to you? And he goes, Dead. Dead is old. Any day of the week, you can get a free DVD player in this building. And, He says, okay, so I'm walking by the common area, and inside the common area, there's an old guy, like 94, 95 years old. He had just gotten out of the hospital. He had just had surgery, and he has Medicare. He has secondary insurance, but he was kind of freaking out. He was almost crying because he had gotten two more bills, one from the hospital, one from the surgeon, for more money, for like 30 grand, 35 grand, and he was really upset. My dad pauses, and he goes, can you believe people think they got to pay hospital bills? I was like, Dad, they're bills. People pay bills. And he's like, not a hospital. You die on a hospital money, that's a win right there. You send them $5 a month, you're trying. They can't do anything. Can't put a lien on anything or garnish your wages. And if that hospital gets any kind of federal funding, they have to do a certain amount of sliding fee scale billing. They don't want to give you the paperwork, but eventually, I'm like, pardon me, Mr. Incredible, while I take notes and tell several hundred people in Minnesota. You ever see The Incredibles? The most heroic moment of The Incredibles was when that guy finds that paperwork for that old lady. And the rest of the movie, quite nice. But that movie, heroic. Okay. My dad says, I can't handle it. So I go in and I tell the guy, I'm like, get the bills, get your checkbook, we'll come into my apartment, we'll take care of this. So they go back into my dad's apartment, and then my dad gets to call the hospital billing. Fun! It's his favorite thing. So he calls the hospital billing, and he's talking to this woman. He's like, I'm talking to this woman, and I was like, so my buddy owes you $17,000. I'm sitting next to him. You're never going to see this money. And the hospital billing lady's like, but he was in the hospital. And my dad's like, you've already been paid twice. Medicare, secondary insurance, you're triple dipping. I'm sitting right next to him. He's not going to make it. He's barely sitting up. He was in the hospital just a minute ago. Did you know that? The woman goes, he's not going to make it? Well, just, could he give us like $600 over the phone with a routing number and then we'll write it off? And my dad's like, yeah, we could totally do that. So they give him a routing number and they hang up. And my dad goes, now we're going to go talk to the surgeon. He's right here in Milwaukee. I'll drive. Lincoln Town Car, 99. They get into the car at around 4:30 in the afternoon on a Thursday. They drive to the surgeon's office. And my dad goes into the surgeon's office. He goes up to the receptionist and says, my buddy owes you 15 grand. He's here. He's got his checkbook. We'd love to talk to the surgeon. The receptionist is like, please come and sit down. So it's 5 to 5 on a Thursday. And my dad is like, starts in with the surgeon. He's like, yeah, you're never going to see this money. Look at this guy. He can barely sit up. He just had surgery. And the surgeon's like, but I did the surgery. He's like, you're triple dipping. You're never going to see this money. Surgeon lasted almost an hour 15. Finally said, give me $200. Get the heck out of my office. So they write the check. And they're driving home. And my dad goes, so we're driving home. And I say to the old guy, let's stop at McDonald's and get a senior coffee. You could buy me a senior coffee. Get this, guy would not buy me a senior coffee. 59-cent senior coffee, guy wouldn't do it. And I was like, Dad, why would that guy want to spend another heartbeat with you? You just spent 5 hours telling anyone who would listen that he was a dead person. He's like, yeah, but I just saved him like 30 grand. And I was like, did you do it for the coffee? And he's like, yeah. I need to get paid a lot. I just need something. Anyway. My father is, he's a good guy. When I had breakfast with him, he said, you know, your Uncle Johnny's son Jimmy has the dream job. And I was like, yeah, you know, I'm on TV sometimes, Dad. What's the dream job? And he goes, he drives a cement truck. I was like, wait, that's the dream job? And he goes, yeah, you know, the truck that spins? He gets to drive that truck. I was like, yeah, that's the dream job. He said, yeah, you just drive up into buildings and pour cement. I'm like, wait, driving a cement truck is the dream job. And my dad goes, it's the truck that spins, Jackie. So inside of my very sophisticated 84-year-old father is a toddler who would desperately like to drive a concrete mixer. I have been corrected.